is exactly what we are going to talk to here. Thank you very much.
सर्व में विराजमान परम मां शक्ति परम पिता ने मारा नमस्कार. द मास्टर हियर हैज मेड अ रियलिटी हियर अ ग्रेट पिरामिड. यस सर, व्हाट यू वांट? ओह, ऑल लाइक दिस. ओके, आई एम द फैन ऑफ अ पिरामिड सिंस 45 इयर्स. आई रेड वन बुक रिटन बाय अमेरिकन spy about Russia, Russian healing system. The name of the book I will give, Mystery Behind the Iron Curtain. So in that book, written in 1970, in that book they have given one small experiment that in the jail they used to give a shaving blade, but that shaving blade you have to use for minimum 1 month, minimum, no other blade. So he thought what to do. He got the idea, he made the small paper pyramid and put the blade inside and automatically it was sharpened. And he patented this idea in Russia. See how is the thing. But today I'm not going to talk about pyramid because there are many masters, but I'm going to give you some other example. I read Sant Kabir ji. I got one simple thing there. He says, Hari Anant. Hari Anant, that means the God particle or God or super energy, whatever you say. It is infinite, beyond everything. But Hari Katha Ananta, that means to know Hari, there are millions of ways. All road goes to him only. But the most important thing here is you select any road, stick to that road, you will definitely reach the destination. Thank you.
My dear friends, my dear masters, and my dear gods, welcome to the great master Digvijay Singh ji. We are very, very happy and speaking after a long time. So give a big clap to Swamiji. I request everybody to stand up and give him a big clap. He's a great son of the soil. And one of the most popular human being in India, as far as I know. Swamiji, we are very, very happy that you are here. Thank you, sir. And please give a big clap, Swamiji, again.
Most respected Brahmarishi Patriji, let me first confess, I'm not neither a Swami nor a Yogi. I'm a pure and simple Bhogi.
If you are with all the Swamijis, you are a Swamiji.
Most respected, all the dignitaries on the dais, one of the most eminent policemen, but now the thread amongst all the spiritual activity in this country, D.R. Karthikeyan ji, Dr. Nipa Das ji, Dr. B.M. Hegde ji, Dr. Paul Nguyen ji, Dr. Patrick K. Potter, Dr. Jane Turnell Reed, Dr. Irina Kosovskaya, and of course, Shreyans Daga, who's of course a family friend, a very old family friend, and the person who has made this valley what it is, Mr. Reddy, Rita Mahajanji, Mr. Bhatt, Dr. Newton, and all the distinguished guests, the followers of, and the members of the Pyramid Spiritual Societies movement. The world of quantum energy medicine is something which I heard for the first time from my dear friend Shreyans Daga. It is a world by itself, and also I must confess that spiritualism and science, I always thought them to be two different ways of achieving what you want to. But here Brahmarishi ji has brought spiritualism and science together. This unique marriage of spiritualism and science is what is the need of the hour. We somehow today are trying to sort of give a scientific color to the myth and mythology in this country. What is most important is to understand that what is the ethos, what is the essence of spiritualism, rather than rely and believe the myth and the mythology in our Indian history. Pyramid, of course, is something which we all know, which conserves, which was the science developed by the Egyptian civilization, where they could keep corpse for a period which is unlimited. But at the same time, using pyramid for conservation, as Mr. Bhatt has rightly said, it was experimented and it can preserve. So anything which can preserve without any external energy is by itself is something which we have to understand and put it into practice. In fact, I have always been looking at alternate medicines. I must bring to your notice a personal tragedy in my family. Last 5 years, my wife was a patient of cancer. She was diagnosed at a later stage of fourth stage cancer. I took her to the best hospital in Houston, MD Anderson. But unfortunately, after 3.5 to 4 years of treatment, I couldn't save her. Then my daughter, she's 37-year-old, she had cancer of the appendix, which is one of the very rare cancers, I'm told. Again, I took her to the MD Anderson, Houston. She was operated 4 times in 3 years, given chemotherapy. And ultimately, 2 months back, they told me that, sorry, Mr. Singh, we have no answer to this now. You give her palliative care. I brought her back to India, and at the same time, we were looking for alternate medicines. She on her own found this cannabis oil treatment, which was developed in California. And she is under cannabis oil treatment. Now, cannabis is a drug which is, you can be convicted for that. I was intrigued. On my own, I found out the most of the sadhu mahatmas in this country, they take cannabis. So I sent a few people to find out if he has heard of any sadhu mahatma who's got cancer, who's a frequent smoker of cannabis. And to my surprise, I found that most of these sadhu mahatmas don't have any incidence of cancer. Then another relation of mine, he's 92, and he doesn't take any medicine, and but he's of course illegally, he's grown cannabis in his backyard, and is religiously taking his smoke of cannabis, and he's quite healthy. So this, in this age, where even in the worst of economic recessions, the pharmaceutical companies are always doing well. And the expenses which incur is unbearable for any family. And more so in a country like India, where incidence of cancer is growing. And each day, the treatment is becoming more and more expensive. I think the time has come now when we have to look at the alternate forms of medicine. And this is where I think, of course, Charak, who gave Ayurveda to India, and of course, Germany gave us, Dr. Herman gave us homeopathy. What I have always felt was, and rightly pointed out by Dr. Newton, if we practice dhyan, pranayam, or the combination of two, which is meditation, I think the old proverb of prevention is better than cure can be easily achieved. I have been practicing yoga, and of course I was taught by Swami Sudarshanacharya of Hyderabad, dhyan and pranayam, and it has held me in good stead. I have my annual checkups, and I can confess that Dr. Naresh Trehan, who's a very famous cardiosurgeon in Delhi, every time he sees my reports, he says, "Digvijay Singh ji, another year of all your opponents to be very disappointed that you are enjoying a good health." I think this is something which has to be encouraged. And Shreyans has brought the masters of all over to this forum is something which is very heartening and very encouraging. Swamiji, of course, of what little I've come to know of you, you are different. Because Swamijis that we see these days, they create cult for themselves. If you go to any place, you only see themselves, them larger than life projected. I've been in touch with a lot of Swamis, but I must confess, you are different. Would any other Swami do what he did to me? The fact remains that there is so much of knowledge in this world, in the universe, and we've got millions and millions of people who have done research on this. But at the same time, there is a need to bring all these masters together, to bring all this wealth of knowledge on a platform, put in a thread, in a garland form, so that we can serve the humanity. Now, let us not forget the Indian religion, which is called Hindu religion, which has nothing to do with religion. Hindu is a Persian word used by the Persians for people living on the other side of River Sindh, because they pronounce sir as her. So in fact, there is no such religion as Hindu religion. We have Sanatana Dharma. Sanatan means which has no end, which is ultimate, which is infinite. That is the Indian religion. And the ethos of Indian religion is Tat Tvam Asi, that you are. And you yourself is the embodiment of God, the ultimate. It is only how you live, how you behave, is ultimate religion. I was very happy to know that Kabir is an inspiration for Mr. Bhatt and of course our Brahm Rishi ji. I have always felt that here was a human in the hierarchy of the Indian system, an untouchable, a Julaha, a Muslim, who understood the ethos of Sanatan Dharma and brought the ethos of Sanatan Dharma into the most simple form of language through his utterances. This is what Sanatan Dharma is, that it is you yourself who can improve, who can ultimately be the deliverer, a person who can deliver to the humanity. I've always felt there's neither hell nor heaven. All the hell and heaven is on this earth, on what we live, what we get, and what we receive. So therefore, I think this is a different interpretations have been given to this Tattvamasi from thousands of years, and of course Adi Shankaracharya ji brought it to the principle Advait, which is of course it will be interpreted by different people differently. But what is most important is that a human being, he starts his life with the breath, and the moment the breath goes away, you are no more. And I think how you breathe in, how do you breathe out, is the essence of life. How you breathe in, how you breathe out, and when, how you think, is the combination of dhyana and pranayama, and that is what, to which I understand, is meditation. And therefore, I think another important thing which I saw in Brahm Rishi ji's this thing is that he says, don't utter any mantra. Don't divert your mind to anything else. Just clean your mind so that